Hi everybody, feel warmly welcome to Usitility. Today is special, we are going to see how to run Boku Boku on PC, now you are displaying it on screen. We will be able to simply download and install Boku Boku and enjoy the game on a Windows PC with gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and large monitor. So it's time to have fun, let's get to it. Before anything else mates, to start we need to open our favorite browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to the next URL I have highlighted in green. Now, you can discover on the screen. You don't need to type it, simply because there's a link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. After we click on this link, we arrive here on the side of LDPlayer. No panic, it is just the Android emulator that we will use to enjoy the game Boku Boku on our PC. It is now obvious that we have a number of advantages of preferring using the emulator: custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, etc. So we are ready to start downloading the Boku Boku by simply clicking on the button Download LDPlayer on PC that you can visualize here in green color. Next step is clicking on it. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Voila, this is the download. It's an executable file. What we have to do is to run the executable file, so we need to click on this file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make modifications to the system. We said yes. I minimized the internet browser to find the installation software better. The installation software is really easy to understand. It contains a couple of options: install, and setup path. I am going to show you what setup path does. We just simply click on it. And therefore we note that we've got here the path where the emulator will be installed. If we prefer to change this directory, we are required to click on that browse button, and we select another folder and install the emulator exactly where we want. To keep it simple, just keep it by default. I simply click on back. Therefore I simply click install. At this time, before beginning setting up this emulator, it is possible that it will suggest us one or more computer software packages to put on our PC. As I do not want to have any of these software, I simply click many times on the reject button. Fantastic! The setup commences and it is going to continue with the download of those megabytes which are shown on our screen. When you save it on your hard drive, it might possibly be more or less megabytes. The download speed may go at a higher speed or slower, based on your type of connection and according to the performance of the emulator hosting servers. Right now they're going extremely fast. The download has been successful, and so at present it continues on with the installation phase. The setup will take more or less time primarily based on the strength of your PC. The more powerful it is, the faster the installation time and vice versa. If we combine the download and installation step, it may take quite a while, so show patience. It is by now completely finished on my side. Currently let's move on to open the emulator for the very first time. We click here on the start button and the emulator is actually launched. As you can discover, down here, we have a progress bar which will fill up, and when it gets into the end, the emulator is going to be started for the first time. Indeed, the emulator was already started, there for the first time. Here is the emulator desktop. Below we have it. Before we keep going, as you can see now, it has made a couple of icons here on the computer desktop. The LD player and LD multiplayer. Note that the LD player icon will be the only one we're interested in. Whenever we are planning to start Boku Boku on our PC, we double click on this specific icon and as a result use the emulator. The LD multiplayer app icon is not related to multiplayer or anything like this. In reality, it is an software icon that we would probably never make use of. Shall we perform the next phase, which is actually a must, and that is to log on to the Google Play Store. To execute this we will go here to System Apps, we click on. And we'll simply click on Play Store. As you can view, the Google Play is started. At this point we have got to sign in. So now as soon as we're right here, we are required to do this next step that is absolutely mandatory. Therefore click on Sign In. Presently it shows checking info. It could occasionally get stuck in checking info and it isn't going to move forward. In this case, you could attempt to connect to your account after a few hours and it will quite likely be fixed. At this time we're going to provide our username and password. The email ought to be a Gmail email and its associated password. As an example, you can use the same email you're using right now in your YouTube account. So I am going to type my data and I will revisit after I have completed it. Voila, details typed in. Find out Google welcoming us and offering us the twos. We are going to agree to them all by just clicking on I agree. Following that, it makes possible to save to the Google Cloud. You might leave it checked, it's going to create a backup of your data files on this device to Google Drive. I won't check it, you do what you want. We mouse click on accept. By now Google Play is started as preferred choice and instantly. In the event that the Google Play is not started automatically and you don't know how to start it by yourself, I assist you how to do it. The very first thing is to proceed to the emulator desktop by clicking on this icon marked in green. Straight away we head to the System Apps folder. And we select the Play Store icon. Yes, we are right here inside of Google Play. What we will do will be go here to search for apps and games. And thus we are going to locate Boku Boku. Currently there we have it, we will go through the first result. Listed here we have got the game app. How about we click on here on the install link that I'm displaying now in green color. That click will commence the software installation. Right now it will install the game, it will take a bit of time or perhaps it may be very fast. It all is subject to on our web connection. It has already completed installing. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by pressing this specific option that I am highlighting in green, that allows you to launch Boku Boku for the first time. You are now on the emulator desktop, and so we are going to click on that new Boku Boku app icon which was provided. Your video game is started for the very first time. Currently there we have it, I can also click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I have to discuss the sound level of that emulator. It is here. We have got the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume, this way we don't use the Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of the emulator. And also to take pleasure in the experience to the maximum, we should turn on the big screen, for which we have two options. This one is actually the very first one, we mouse click on this icon which I am mentioning in green color. Now please take full advantage of your display screen, getting one border on top, one at the right and the third one at the bottom. Granted that we would like to play the app in full screen, we click this particular icon. And thus we would likely presently be experiencing and enjoying the video game in full screen setting. To exit the 100% screen functionality, just click the F11 key. And additionally we would probably currently play in normal screen setting. At present, I am choosing to explain you the keys mapping which is rather interesting. This step we definitely will be able to use the game far more easily. The first thing is to click on this app icon. And at this time there you will be able to complete the appropriate adjustments. I am going to put the default configuration, though if you intend to change it, you can also do this without any problem. I grab this occasion to say that on occasion, when beginning the game a dark screen appears, if that is so and you get the black screen and the emulator does not launch, I comment a feasible solution. We can browse here, to the cogwheel. In your emulator options, in the advanced selection we have got numerous image resolutions. That is the resolution we have previously decided to go with by default and we should select any of these additional resolutions, for example this one below. We take it and consequently click on save. It is going to ask us to reboot the emulator and when rebooted, likely the emulator will start and the black screen will be completely removed. Obviously, the emulator is entirely in our own language. On occasion it happens that the emulator is started in the wrong language, as an example, in Mandarin. And as a consequence to place it in the proper language we go there to the cogwheel. And thus there throughout various other configurations, we click on the language drop down. We can easily choose the language we like, German, Mandarin, etc. Once the language is chosen, we are going to save, the emulator would restart, and the game, next time we launch it, would of course be in the specified language. So now, there's another thing that we need to take into account, and it is that we will get a message from Gmail indicating that a different electronic device has been connected to our Google account. It should check with us if we are the ones who have connected that device. Absolutely, we shouldn't get worried, simply because the emulator is acting as an Android tablet or smartphone. So you can find which smartphone or tablet is currently being emulated, we arrive here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. Let's go here to the model selection. And there we discover that the emulator is emulating a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for our video tutorial. I believe you liked it, specifically that you found it interesting. If that is so, give it a good like, subscribe to my channel, and I will be happy to answer your comments, questions or suggestions, let them in the comment box below. You could even leave comments on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams occasionally, you get it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Just click on any of those instructional videos that happens to be showing up on the list of videos to watch and see you in the next video game videos. Bye.